Hello friends, in this lecture we will see one of the important methods of assembly line balancing. Okay, that is rank position weight method. See here, I have written it rank position weight method and the other name is Helgesen and Burin method. Okay, so it is a combination of Helgesen and Burin method. These are the name of two scientists who have given this method. So this is also known as Helgesen and Burin method or rank position weight method. In short, you can write RPWM. Okay, rank position weight method, that is RPWM. Okay, so basically it is one of the method which is used to design the assembly line. Okay, suppose we have got some activities. Okay, we have got some activities to complete a task. So how to form the workstations? Okay, how to form the workstations? Which activities should be allocated to which workstations? That can be decided with the help of rank position weight method. Okay, so in this method, what we are trying to do, we are trying to assign different positional weight to the each work element. Okay, we are trying to assign different positional weight to each work element. So how we are going to do it? We have taken a network diagram. Okay, it is one of the random network diagram I have taken for the example. So it is one of the network diagram. The work elements are 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8, and these numbers 8 4 6 2 5 7 5 4, these represent their activity completion time. Okay, so this is a network diagram consisting of 8 work elements and their corresponding activity completion time has been given. So how to find the rank, how to find the positional weight? So this method has got some steps. Okay, so I am going to write the steps and we will take the example and we will try to solve this method. Okay, so the first step is says that, okay, the steps, okay, the first step is say that arrange all the elements in decreasing order of their positional weight. Okay, so it says that arrange all the elements in decreasing order of their positional weight. Here, very important word, decreasing order of their positional weight. Okay, so we will arrange them in decreasing order of their positional weight, but the question is, what is positional weight? How to decide the positional weight? Okay, so the second step, that what is the positional weight? Okay, how we are going to decide the positional weight of each of the work element in this network diagram? So it says that positional weight of an element corresponds to the longest time duration. Okay, corresponds to the longest time duration starting from that element. Starting from that element through the remaining network diagram. Okay, so what does it, this statement means? Okay, we will see it. So it says that if you want to find the rank positional or positional weight, then it is the time duration स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम दैट एलिमेंट थ्रू द लॉन्गेस्ट नेटवर्क डायग्राम. ओके सो सपोज वी हैव टू फाइंड द रैंक पोजिशन फॉर द वर्क एलिमेंट 1. ओके सो हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड इट. सो सपोज वी हैव टू फाइंड द रैंक पोजिशन फॉर वर्क एलिमेंट 1. ओके वी हैव गॉट वर्क एलिमेंट 1 एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द रैंक पोजिशन ऑफ वर्क एलिमेंट 1. सो हाउ वी विल डू इट. सिंपली एड द टाइम ड्यूरेशन. ओके वी हैव टू फाइंड द लॉन्गेस्ट टाइम ड्यूरेशन. सो starting from one we have to move through the entire network diagram. Keeping in mind that which of the paths is the longest. Okay, we have to move through the longest network diagram, you can say. Starting from that element, we have to move through the longest network diagram, and that will be the positional weight of each of the work element. Okay, so for 1 we will start from 1. So for 1 it is 8. So simply 8 plus the second one is 4. Now from 4 we can either follow this network diagram or we can follow this network diagram. Okay, we have to select the longest path. So here it is 6 plus 2 8 and here it is 5 plus 7 12. So we will not select this path, we will move through this path. Why? Because moving through this path will give us 12 and moving through this path will give us only 8. So 12 is largest, so we have to select the largest. So 8 plus 4 plus 5 plus 7, you can say, plus 5 plus 7. Now from 7 we will go to 5 plus 4. Okay, simply add it. So it is going to be 33. Okay, 12, 24, 28 and 33. Okay, so this 33 is the positional weight for element 1. Okay, now for second, now for 2, just write it. So for 2, we have to start from 2 only. Okay, we have to start from 2 only and we have to move through the longest network diagram. So for 2, it is 4. So 4 plus, again we have got two paths, 12 and 8. So which one is the largest? This 12 is the largest. We will not select this 8, we will select this 12. So this is 12 plus 5 plus 4. Okay, for 7 and 8 it is 5 plus 4. So this is going to be 25. So we can say that this 25 is the positional weight for work element 2. Now for work element 3. Look here, for work element 3 we have to start from the 3 only. So it is going to be 6 plus 2 plus 5 plus 4. So it is going to be 17. Okay, so for 3 the work positional weight is 17. Now for work element 4. Okay, so for 4 we have to start from the work element 4 only. Okay, so it is going to be 5 plus 7, this is 12. 12 plus 9, this is going to be 21. So it is going to be 5 plus 7 plus 5 plus 4 equals to 21. So just start from that work element and move through the longest network diagram. Okay, so in this way we can provide the positional weight. Now for 5 we can write it. For 5 we will start from 5 only. So 2 plus 5 plus 4, so this is going to be 11. Okay, so for 5 it is 11. For 6 we will start from 6 only. So for 6 it is 7 plus 5 plus 4. So it is 16. And for 7. For 7 it is 5 plus 4, 9. And for 8 it is. For 8 it is 4. Okay, so we have found the positional weight of each of the work element. Now you have to arrange the elements in decreasing order of their positional weight. Okay, so highest you can say 33. So it will go first. Okay, the second highest is 25. So it is going to be second. Okay, now it is third. So in this way you can find the decreasing order from highest to the lowest, and you have to arrange these work elements in decreasing order of their positional weight. Okay, so like this you can find the positional weight and you can arrange them in decreasing order of their positional weight. Okay, now the third step and most important step. The third step says that allocate the work elements in the allocate the work elements in the workstation in such a way that their workstation time must be less than or equal to the cycle. Okay, so now after arranging them in decreasing order of their positional weight, what we have to do? We have to look for those elements whose workstation total, suppose we have arranged in the first workstation, we have arranged 1, 2, and 3, these three work elements. Okay, so their task time, total task time will give us the summation of total workstation time. So this workstation time must be less than equals to the cycle time. Okay, if it is following, then this will be your workstation number 1. Okay, we will see the example, we will solve everything, but we have to keep in mind that the total workstation time, okay, the allocation should be done in such a way that the total workstation time of the work elements, okay, the total workstation time of the work elements must be less than or equals to the cycle time. TS is the station time and TC is the cycle time. So the total workstation of the work elements must be less than or equals to the cycle time. So these are the three steps and we will see these three steps with the help of some example. So now we will take the example. Okay, now we will take the example. The example says that design an assembly line using rank position weight method RPWM. Design an assembly line using rank position weight method and also find balance delay and line efficiency. And it is given that take cycle time, that is TC, equals to 18 minutes. Okay, so we have to design an assembly line using rank position weight method. Okay, we have to use rank position weight method. We have to also find the balance delay, we have to also find the line efficiency, and the cycle time, that is TC, is given 18 minutes. Okay, so we will first take the table of activity, their precedence and task time. So the table is given like this. Activity, their task time, or you can say activity completion time is given, and the precedence is also given. So activity is 13 activities has been given. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Okay, so these 13 activities has been given and their task time and precedence is also given. I will write it for you. So in this way we have been given an example. Okay, we have been given an example which consists of activity, their task time and precedence, and we have been told to design the assembly line using rank position weight method. Okay, so what we have to do? First we have to draw the network diagram. You can see the activity, their precedence and the task time is given, so we have to draw the network diagram. Okay, we have to draw the network diagram. Which network diagram? Activity on node. Okay, I have already told you that in case of assembly line balancing, we use AON network diagram. So activity on node will be drawn. Okay, so the first activity is activity one and the precedence is none. So the first activity we are going to start is activity one. The first activity we are going to start is activity number one. The second, for activity two, the precedence is one. For activity two, the precedence is one. So we will draw activity two. For three, the precedence is again one. So for three, the precedence is one. Okay. For activity four, the precedence is again one. So for four also, the precedence is one. Okay, like this. Okay. You have been told everything in the PERT and CPM how to draw the network diagram. So for activity 5, you can say for activity 5 the precedence is 2. For activity 5 the precedence is 2. For activity 6 the precedence is 4. For activity 6 the precedence is 4. So we have to draw activity 6 and the precedence is 4. For activity 7 the precedence is 3, 5 and 6. So for 3 and 5 and 6 the precedence is 7. So we have to match them. Okay, 3, 5 and 6 like this. Okay, for 8 the precedence is 7. For 8 the precedence is 7. For 9 also the precedence is 7. For 9 also the precedence is 7. Okay, and for 10 also the precedence is 7. For 10 also the precedence is 7. For 11 the precedence is 8. For 11 the precedence is 8. For 12 the precedence is 10. So 12 will start from here. Okay, the precedence is 10. Now the last activity 13, the precedence is 9, 11 and 12. So we will draw it like this. Okay, we will draw it like this. Now we will write the here task completion time. For 1 it is 8, for 2 it is 3, for 3 it is 3, for 4 it is 3. Okay, why we are writing it? Because we have to find the rank position. For 5 it is 6, for 6 it is 7, for 7 it is 5, for 8 it is 3, for 9 it is 2, for 10 it is 5, for 11 it is 8, for 12 it is 5 and for 13 it is 10. Okay, now we have drawn the network diagram. We have to find the positional weight or rank position. Okay, positional weight. So how we are going to do it? Okay, this is activity 1. Okay, for activity 1 we have to start from activity 1 only. So the time is 8. 8. Now we have got two paths. Okay, we have got three paths. Here it is 9, here it is 3 and here it is 10. So which is the longest? This 10 is the longest. So we will select this one. So it is 8 plus 3 plus 7, that is 10, plus 5. Now again we have got three paths. So here it is 11, here it is 2 and here it is 10. So which is the longest? This 11 is the longest. Okay, each and every state I am going to tell you. Now the last one is 10. So add it. So I think you will get 18, 10, 28, 28 and 5, 33, 33 and 4, 11. This is going to be 44. So for one we have got the positional weight. Okay, so like this you can find the positional weight of each and every work element. For 2 you can find. Okay, for 2 just subtract 8 in this 44. Okay, so for 2 I am writing it. It is starting from the work element 2. So this is 3, then 6, then 5. Now here the longest is 11. So this is 11 plus 10 like this. Okay, so this is how much? 21, 26, 32 and 35. Just subtract 8. This is 36, I think. okay, so just calculate it, okay, just calculate it, the positional weight for two it is 35, okay, so just calculate the positional weight in this manner and arrange them, okay, arrange them, make a column of positional weight and arrange them in decreasing order of their positional weight and just write the positional weight. You can write also of the positional weight here, like 44, okay, this is the positional weight 44, this is 35 for 2. So for each and every element write the positional weight and arrange them in decreasing order of their rank position, okay. So we have found the positional weight, okay, positional weight of each of the element, okay, just at the activity time, okay, just at the activity time starting from the each work element to the last network, and it should be longest network, okay. So we have calculated and we have written the positional weight with the blue marker, okay. You can see for 1 it is 44, for 2 it is 35, for 4 it is 36. So we have written the positional weight of the each work element with the blue marker and the black numbers represent their activity completion time, okay. So we have made the table, okay, we have made the table. The first is element and their activity completion time. So we have to arrange these elements according to their rank position or positional weight. So we have already arranged them, okay. One it is highest and for one it is 44, so we will write it, okay. So for one it is 44, the positional weight is 44. The next one is 4, for 4 it is 36, so we will write here. For 2 it is 35, so we have to arrange them in decreasing order of their positional weight. So this rule is all about arrange the work element in decreasing order of their positional weight. For 6 it is 33, for 5 it is 32, next is 3, for 3 it is 29, next is 7, for 7 it is 26, for 8, okay, for 8 it is 21, for 10 it is 20, okay, you can see, for 10 it is 20, for 11 it has 18, okay, so 11, for 11 it is 18, for 12 it is 15, For 9 it is 12, and for 13 it is 10. Okay, so we have arranged them in decreasing order of their positional weight and we have written the positional weight of the each element, okay, in their decreasing order. Okay, now we have to form the workstation and we have to calculate the line efficiency and balance delay. Okay, so just look here, so be attentive. So this TS represents the station time, okay. TS is station time. So we have to find the station time. Okay, we have to find the station time. It means we have to allot these work station into work stations. Okay, so it may be possible that 1, 2, 3, okay, 2 or 3 elements are assigned to a single work station. Next, 2 or 3 elements are assigned to the another work station. So how to decide the work station? Okay, so what you have to do, just look at their station time, okay. For 1 it is 8, for 4 it is 3, for 2 it is 3, so just add it, 8 plus 3 plus 3 it is 14, and for 6 it is 7, for 14 plus 7 it is going to be 21, okay. So suppose we have taken the work element 1 2 and 4, okay, 1 2 and 4, so 8 3 and 3 this is 14, okay. And if you are going to take the element 6, okay, if you are going to take the element 6 also, so the total time will be 8 plus 3, 11, 11 plus 3, 14, and 14 plus 7, it is going to be 21. So the rule says that the total station time must be less than or equal to the cycle time. So the cycle time here is 18 minutes. So we have to assign those elements in the first work station whose total sum or total work station time must be less than equals to 18 minutes. So 8, 3, 11 and 3, 14. If you are going to take the work element 6, so the work station time is going to be 21. 21 become greater than 81. So that is not allowed. It means 1, 4 and 3 will go into the workstation 1. Okay. So we can do it like this. The 1, 4 and 3. Okay. This 1, 4 and 3. This 1, 4 and 3 will go into the workstation 1. So we can write here. This 1, 4 and 2. 1, 4 and 2 will form the workstation 1. Like this. 1, 4 and 2. This one will make the workstation 1. The total work element must be less than equals to 18. So the total station time, we can say that the total station time, it is going to be 8 plus 3 plus 3. The total station time is 8 plus 3 plus 3. So total it is going to be 14. Okay, total it is going to be 14. And the ideal time, you know, ideal time is going to be the difference of cycle time. Here you can write, the ideal time is going to be the difference of cycle time minus the station time. So it is going to be 18 minus 14. So for the first work station, the ideal time is 4. Okay, so we have classified 1, 2 and 4 into the work station 1. Okay, now the second, 7 plus 6, it is going to be 13, and 13 plus 6, it is going to be 16, and 16 plus 5, it is going to be 21. So we can say that 6, 5 and 3, it is going to be the workstation 2. Okay, 6, 5 and 3, it is going to be the workstation 2. Why? Because you can add the total workstation time. It is going to be 7 plus 6 plus 3. 7 plus 6 plus 3. So it is going to be 16. Okay, it is going to be 16. And this 16 is less than the cycle time. If you are going to take this 7, so it will make it 21. So that is not allowed. So it is going to be 18 minus 16. So it becomes 2. So our next workstation is 6, 5 and 3. So here we can do it like this. 6, 5 and 3. It goes into the workstation number 2. It goes into the workstation number 2. Okay. Very simple. Now look for the next. 5, 3, 8 and this is 13. If you are going to take it 8, then it will become 21. So 7, 8 and 10 is going to make the workstation number 3. It is going to make the workstation number 3. So 7, 8 and 10. You can write here 7, 8 and 10. This is the workstation 3. Okay, already I have denoted it in the network diagram. Okay, so 7, 8 and 10, it is going to make the workstation 3. And the total time it is going to take is 5 plus 3 plus 5. 5 plus 3 plus 5. So it is going to be 13. So the ideal time will be 18 minus 13. It is going to be 5. Okay, so we have formed the third workstation. Now the four work elements are remaining. So 8 plus 2 plus 5, it is going to be 15. Okay, and 15 plus 10, it is going to be 25. So these three will make the workstation number 4, and the last one, okay, the last element, that is work element 13, it is going to make the workstation number 5. So here 11, 12 and 9, this will make the workstation 4, and this one the fifth workstation. Okay, the 13 one will make the fifth workstation, and 11, 12 and 9 is going to make the fourth workstation. So the total time here is 8 plus 2, 10, and 10 and 5, 15. So it is going to be 15, and here it is going to be 18 minus 15, 3, and here it is going to be 10, and 18 minus 10, it is going to be 8. Okay, so in this way, we have formed the workstation, we have calculated the workstation time, we have calculated the ideal time. Okay, now we have to calculate the efficiency and balance delay. So the first formula, they are saying that calculate the balance delay. So balance delay, we know that the total ideal time upon number of work stations into TC into 100. Okay, very simple formula. So the total ideal time, you can calculate 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 5, 11, 11 plus 3, 14, and 14 plus 8, it is going to be 22. Okay, it is going to be 22. 4 to 6, 6 and 5, 11, 11, 3, 14, and 14 at 8, it is going to make 18. 14 at 8, it is going to make 22. So, total ideal time, summation of all, 4 plus 2 plus 5 plus 3 plus 8, okay, divided by total number of work station, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 work station, and the cycle time is 18 into 100. So just you are going to write the answer, okay. So it is going to be 24.44, okay, it is going to be 24.44, okay. So you have to calculate the balance delay. So balance delay is 24.44. So once you have find the balance delay, you know how to calculate the line efficiency, okay. So for line efficiency, you know that line efficiency is 100 minus balance delay, okay. So 100 minus 24.44, so it is going to be 75.56, okay, percent. So line efficiency you have also calculated and balance delay you have also calculated. So in this way you can calculate the given data, okay. So what you have to do, you have to make the network diagram, okay. You have to make the network diagram, you have to assign the positional weight to each of the work element. The positional weight is the summation of the activity completion time starting from that activity to the entire network of the longest path, and arrange the work element in decreasing order of their positional weight. You can see we have arranged them in decreasing order of their positional weight. Now we have to calculate the station time in this way. You can calculate the station time, and after calculation of the station time is going to be the summation of the activity completion time in such a way that the total station time must be less than equals to the cycle time. Okay, you have to take care the total station time must be less than or equal to the cycle time. Here the cycle time was 18, okay, the cycle time was 18. So you can see 14, 16, 13. Now calculate the ideal time, that is difference between cycle time and station time. We have calculated the ideal time, okay, we have calculated the ideal time. After that, summation of the ideal time, 4, 2, 6, 5, 11, 3, 14, and 8, 22. So you can calculate the balance delay and line efficiency at 100 minus balance delay. So in this way, this is all about rank position weight method or Helgerson Berin method. So you can go through this process, okay. This is all about just, it is little bit of lengthy, but you have to do it, okay. In the university examination or UPSC examination, these type of questions are going to be asked. So you need to practice these type of concepts also. Very simple, just follow the steps. Thank you.